Christmas, boys and girls. It is that time of year. We got a lovely holiday quiz. This time it is not by me. It is by our lovely co-host, Max. He's the one that did this quiz for us.
Yep, and what we have for you today is Guess the Christmas Music. And so each question is worth 2 points. One, you got to get the song title. Two, you got to tell me who sang it.
All right.
Are you ready for number one? You flip, I got the gills, but I'm going to need a title as well.
Yeah, I'm sending the title.
Okay. All right, dang, calm down. Don't be so aggressive with me.
I got it.
I hope that's the name of the song. I have no clue otherwise what it would be called.
That's what I'm hoping.
All right, so Jacob guessing question mark for both, so yep. that's gonna be a zero. Bobby gave me the right group. Now, Philip, I'll let you get this. The title is called I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus.
I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus.
Bobby put mommy kissing Santa Claus.
Oh, my goodness.
Right? Did Philip get the title exactly right?
Yes.
Okay, then I would say you had to get it exactly right.
There you go, Bobby. Blame Jacob.
What?
My Achilles heels always.
That's how we've done it in the past. If someone else got it exactly right, then the other person doesn't get it.
But that was I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus by the Jackson 5.
Dang, I was going to guess Jackson 5. Maybe I shouldn't have punted that one.
I'm surprised you didn't know that one. I was like, the voice.
Yeah. I was just, I was ready to go to
the You had a lot of. You were quick to quit.
Yeah. All right. I'll do that next time.
It's going to be one that I'm going to regret not knowing. Like, I should have known that.
Number two.
A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben.
Phil has a face that says, I have no clue. I mean, you do get three lessons.
It does sound familiar. I'm going to have to... Yeah.
A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolphin will talk and we'll go for a walk. It's the hope of Janice and Jen.
All right, I don't know who sings. I got the song title, I'm pretty sure. All right.
I got the last name. I can't think of the first name.
So sad. He says some white guy. And then Janice and Jen. Philip, we got both wrong. It's not even a white guy. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas by Johnny Mathis.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
All right.
I got the song right, at least.
Yeah, Bobby and Jacob got the song title right.
See, Philip, shouldn't be assuming it's always a white guy.
All right, number three.
Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee.
Song title's probably going to be easy on this one, but do you know who did this version?
Yeah.
So Bobby's the only one who got both right. Everyone got the song title, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. But Bobby, who sang that?
That was the classic Western star Gene Autry.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose.
Yes, it was.
Couldn't. Would never have gotten that. You could have spelled the whole thing out when it got it.
I mean, I'm sorry, guys. You didn't know it.
All right, number four.
I'm gonna need another lesson.
I know it probably doesn't count as like the artist mix, but that's what I'm gonna have to go with.
Oh, Philip, no. Both the years are wrong. It is Christmas Time Is Here, and it's technically the Vince Guaraldi Trio, but I'll probably give you just Charlie Brown Christmas Special, which Bobby and Jacob both got. Because no one knows it's Vince Guaraldi Trio. Nobody knows that.
The obvious. I was like,
Sometimes it is. Number five.
And we're caroling through the night, and this Christmas.
Probably an easy one.
Is it?
Oh. Depending who you are. Like, for me, yes. Other people, maybe not.
All right. Jacob's the only one who did not get both. He is This Christmas from Chris Brown.
And this Christmas, he'll be a very special Christmas for me.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Jacob put in Neo.
I couldn't tell.
One of my favorite Christmas songs right there. So
what do you want me to do with this?
It was in a movie too. Called This Christmas.
Oh yeah, right. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it was.
Gone away is a bluebird, here to stay is a new bird.
He really hits that bluh sound in a blue. So this is another instance of where Bobby and Jacob did not get the song title because it's not exactly right. Philip did. Dang. No one got the artist right. It's Walking in a Winter Wonderland.
He's singing a song as we go along. Walking in a winter wonderland.
And that one
is also called. It's also just called Winter Wonderland. It's also just called Winter Wonderland.
It's officially called Walking in a Winter Wonderland.
No, sir. Yeah. The Dean Martin version is just called Winter Wonderland.
Is he talking about the Dean Martin version?
This is Dean Martin.
Oh, it is? Okay.
I'll allow it. All right, number 7.
Bells will be ringing.
I'm going to need a replay.
Bells will be ringing the glad, glad news.
Someone got it pretty quickly.
I don't know it. Know it, but I don't.
Jacob got it.
Yeah, I'm pretty confident.
Silver Bells, Sammy Davis Jr., I have no clue.
Jacob, what is it?
Please Come Home for Christmas, Bon Jovi.
Choirs will be singing Silent Night.
Gave me the Bon Jovi version? I was not going to guess.
I could tell immediately that was Bon Jovi, so that's why I knew.
I don't think I've ever heard the Bon Jovi version.
Dude, that's a popular version of that song.
No, you definitely heard it in commercials and in movies.
Like, I usually go with the original.
Oh, yeah, from the 50s, yeah. We're not surprised. All right, number 8.
He's making a list, checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice.
I have no idea who's the people that sing these songs.
Hi, Philip, I'm ready for you.
I got one name.
One of them, I guess, like 5.
All right, so, Jake, I'm just going to help you out here. Your guy's not in this quiz.
Oh.
Did you keep guessing?
He's guessing Fred Astaire.
For a second, I thought you were talking to me. I'm like, no. My guy, who I'm guessing the other times, is definitely in this quiz. There's no way he's not.
Bobby and Philip were correct on both. It's Santa Claus is Coming to Town by Frank Sinatra.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
All right, number 9.
I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer.
I'm gonna keep guessing this guy. It's gotta be.
Right, so Bobby and Jacob are correct on both. It is Holly Jolly Christmas by Burl Ives.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year.
I'm glad that I won the best. I'm glad I knocked him out because he was about to be the next one. I kept guessing.
All right, number 10.
What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away.
I never already guessed this dude, but I'm going to have to guess him again. I insist.
I have no idea, Max. I just made up a name.
Bobby guessed the title or artist as Andy Astaire. Fred Astaire's long lost brother.
You know?
Gotta keep the gag going.
No one got both. Bobby and Philip got the right title, Jingle Bell Rock. Bobby Helms.
That's the Jingle Bell Rock. Jingle Bell Rock.
Nope, was not going to get that. If you gave me 100 guesses, though, I'd have been one.
Can you also say what my guess was?
Oh, yeah. Philip guessed Jingle Bell Rock, Mean Girls.
I mean...
That is the quintessential version.
It's so... Very well popular movie.
Now, this next one is another one that has two titles, so I would accept either one.
All right.
I hope you heard.
No, I don't know that one. I'm gonna have to, I'll listen to it three times. I don't think I'm gonna get it.
I don't know.
Okay. Come on, dude. Now Jake's guessing Adele Astaire.
I had to look up his wife's name.
He had a sister that had a famous duo with.
Maybe that's his sister. Hold on. Oh yeah, no, that was his sister, I guessed. Okay.
Well, Bobby's the only one who got both right.
I'm about to see if he has a wife.
Yeah.
Well, in fact, he's the only one to get anything right. Bobby, what is that one?
John Lennon, War Is Over.
And so this is Christmas. I hope you have fun.
So it's John Lennon, War Is Over, or is also titled Happy Xmas.
Oh,
the more you know.
Yeah. I just remember the kids singing War Is Over. Well, that's probably the name of the song.
Mm-hmm. All right, number 12.
Fire is slowly dying. And my dear, we're still goodbye.
The voice sound like this, but
hi, Jacob, just waiting on you. Don't be afraid to let's do it again. Vitamin J, what are you doing?
What?
Phyllis Astaire? Is that his mother?
No, that's one of his wives who unfortunately apparently had lung cancer and died. So
he's learning a lot about Fred Astaire right now.
Yep. Didn't think we learned so much about his family.
Oh, he had multiple wives. Oh, excellent.
Ah, great. Perfect.
You have kids, Jacob? You can get name out of those kids, too?
I will get back to you on that.
Bobby and Philip were both, they got correct on both. Everyone got the title, Let It Snow. But Bobby and Philip also got that it is Bing Crosby.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
I mean, the voice is
Hey, Max, now you're not going to be able to let anybody who has trivia, you're not going to let any Astaire questions, because we'll know, you know, we got it.
Now we can't do that. 13.
Everything changed, you are me. Underneath the street, I place to be. Throw your phone and the camera to see.
Don't sound like you know it, Jacob.
I'm gonna have to listen. I'm gonna listen to it again.
Someone got it. Both are crazy quick.
The singer is a complete shot in the dark. I just know she does Christmas songs.
Well, for shot in the dark, Jacob, you nailed it. You got both. Bobby and Jacob got both. Philip got one. It is not Whitney Houston. That is Underneath the Tree by Kelly Clarkson.
It sounded like Kelly Clarkson to me, and I just guessed I knew the tree because it was in the lyrics. That's why I had to listen for the third time to hear what she said.
The name was like Underneath the Tree. It's not this. I have no clue.
My wife loves that one.
I just went female singer. Okay, Whitney Houston. Boom.
No. I would guess like because it sounded like a really good singing voice. So you're gonna guess like Kelly Clarkson or like Whitney.
14. Yep.
What? Let's go ahead and give us all the points.
What? Some people might not know it.
Some people might.
I'm saying, Max, Sinatra, better.
You calm down.
So
if we're talking about their acting, sure.
But yes, that was
singer,
a three
better
for three.
Actor.
That was 3 for 3. Blue Christmas by Elvis Presley. But we're not going to get into this right now.
They both are fine in my book.
Pure voice, Sinatra was better.
Sinatra has the better voice, yes.
Number 15.
You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear.
Shania Twain. Jingle Bell Rock Deluxe. I can't remember.
No, Bobby's the one who got both right. By what is it?
Rocking Around the Christmas Tree by Brenda Lee.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop.
Yep, that's it.
The stupid song.
If you say so, I got the song title, but no.
All right, 16.
My world is changing. I'm rearranging.
I don't know. I'm going to have to do this first. I don't know.
I feel like we got a title.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. Nope. Bobby has gotten it both right again as a 6-1 in a row. Bobby, which
It's Faith Hill, Where Are You Christmas?
Where are you Christmas? Why can't I find you?
Oh. Yep. That plays at the end of the Grinch.
I think I'm listening to this credit.
Yep, they made a music video and everything.
You sure that wasn't the Momsen?
What's next? All right,
17.
And Santa Claus has got a toy for every good girl and good little boy.
More time.
And Santa Claus has got a toy for every good girl and good little boy.
Come on now.
Do you need me to tell you what I put? I sent it to you a while ago.
Yeah. My phone photo.
Is it Happy Holidays, Andy Williams?
That is correct.
It's the holiday season, and Santa Claus is coming round.
7 in a row for Bobby. I don't think it's going to change out of this one. I think it's going to continue. All right, number 18, yep. Jake, I didn't get yours yet.
Okay, I can just send it, but I'll tell you. George Michael, This Christmas.
Say it.
You unfortunately are going to be wrong on both accounts.
Oh, really?
It is Last Christmas from Wham.
Last Christmas.
You're wrong on both accounts.
Jake, yeah, sorry, that's can't give that to you.
Man, when you said this, it's definitely last Christmas.
It's last Christmas.
This Christmas is by a different song.
Mm-hmm.
But it was a group Wham, not solo.
Where is the other guy in that clip? Nowhere.
You told him who sang it. I told you who sang it.
What's the other guy's name?
No idea.
I don't know what his name is.
Yeah, okay. Ain't nobody knows dude's name.
Sorry, pal. All right. 19.
Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy, cozy are we. We've snuggled close together like two birds of a feather with me.
All right.
That's what it's called.
I don't know the artist. I might not even get the right title.
So, about your streak's going to come to an end?
Eight straight.
All right. It's not George Austere. Everyone did get the title right. It is Sleigh Ride. And this is another one by Johnny Mathis.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
I didn't know you'd do the same artist two times in one.
I didn't mean to. It just happened.
Okay.
There will be no more repeats from here, though.
Okay.
All right, number 20.
And so I'm offering the simple phrase.
Best Christmas song of all time, At Me.
We settled this in our list last year.
Sings it.
Who has that lovely angelic voice?
Come on, Phil, don't do it.
This one does have an alternate title, Max, but you know.
Gonna need that name.
Okay, I'm just not gonna be able to guess. Just we're gonna go.
It is the Christmas song, which everyone got, by Nat King Cole.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
So was it? I cannot remember. I was like.
Yeah, one of the greatest voices to ever grace this God's green earth, mm-hmm. and you don't know his name,
mm-hmm.
I'm hurt.
And also, just going to throw this out there, we did settle the best Christmas song, and this one didn't win.
Yeah, I did not.
You should have won. Mariah Carey did not win.
It's a queen, I'm sorry.
My bad.
It's definitely Mariah Carey.
All right. I don't think she's top 10. I might even be top 10. Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Get
it's definitely
out of
top 10. It's definitely top 10.
It is top 10, yes.
Christmas song, buddy.
21.
Oh, okay.
You know? My child won't let me type, but I can tell it to you.
Really? Wow. I'll have you say your answer, Jacob, in a minute. All right, Bobby and Philip got it right. It is All I Want for Christmas Is You by Mariah Carey.
Make my wish come true.
Now, Jacob, tell them what you said.
So, yeah, I put Twinkle Twinkle by the Twinkles.
I laughed because we were literally just talking about her.
Yeah, we were. Yeah. I guess I never picked up that the song started with that.
I know. I've listened to that song so many times. All I needed was those three notes. I'm like,
There's a reason I only did that. I was like, all right, this is going to separate the pretenders here.
that's a song. I know that song. Anyway.
What's next?
Man, I'm really gonna fall behind.
I don't know it.
All right, I'm gonna have to play it again.
No idea.
All right, so Bobby and Jacob got nothing. Phil was the only one to get a point on that one. He got the artist correct. Who is the artist?
It is Elton John.
Mm-hmm. And it is the title is Step Into Christmas.
I was like, no, it's dance.
Yeah, I was like, oh, that's so close.
I put dance as well in my title.
That's a Christmas forever.
All right, 23.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why.
Best version of the song. At me, Phil. Best version of the song.
I agree.
Wow. Jackson 5 did it a lot better.
No.
What was that crap? Like, that slow net? Like, what is this mess?
I need that artist, Philip. No, Philip didn't get the artist. Everyone got the title, Santa Claus is Coming to Town, and that is by Bruce Springsteen.
You better not bow, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Yeah, as a white man, I had to know that.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's in our DNA to know it.
It simply is a must.
See, it was such a rough an artist, I didn't even get it right.
Wow. I'm not the biggest Bruce Springsteen fan either, but that's a bit harsh.
24.
Yep.
Home for the holidays. I believe I've missed each and every face.
The songs, too. I know it.
This is a great song.
Boom, Max. I don't even need a repeat. I know it.
All right, Bobby's the only one to get that right. Bobby, what is it?
Celebrate Me Home, Kenny Loggins.
Please celebrate me home. Give me a number. Please celebrate me home.
That is correct. All
so
right.
If I get second place again on a music quiz, I'm going to be mad.
Yeah, especially because twice you, like, botched the song.
Mm-hmm. I think I've been second place 3 or 4 times now. It's ridiculous.
All right, whenever y'all ready, we can play the last one.
Met a man who lives in Tennessee. He was heading for
Pennsylvania, and some homemade pumpkin pie.
I know the song. You
want me to play again?
Help me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Met a man who lives in Tennessee. He was heading for Pennsylvania and some homemade pumpkin pie.
We got the name, we got the song. But who's the artist?
Who's got the clutch gene?
Does this song have two titles, Max?
Possibly, I don't know. I got one on here. I'll let you know.
I feel like it's a different name. I feel like I got the name wrong.
All right, so
I don't know.
It is There's No Place Like Home for the Holidays. And Bobby did get the artist right. It is Perry Como.
Go, there's no place like home for the holidays.
Bobby is our winner.
I finally did it. I finally won the music one. I did it.
Well, congratulations to D3 on winning. Thank you to Max for putting this together. And ladies and gentlemen, until next time, let us know your thoughts on how you did on this quiz. Hopefully you might have done better than us. I mean, I'm not good at music. I've stated this on multiple quizzes. And until next time.
See ya.